32. A multi-hull, as versatile in purpose as the needs and desires of a sailor are varied. With the Gougeon 32, you can enjoy a spur-of-the-moment day excursion, a lengthy adventure, a peaceful, relaxing cruise, a smooth performance, or a fast, exhilarating sail. You can push it to the limit, then quickly tame it to slide gracefully over the waves or slice cleanly through wave tops, making little noise or spray. The Gougeon 32 offers peace of mind to the new sailor and challenges the experienced racer. Nearly 30 years ago, brothers Meade and Jan Gougeon got ice boating fever. The joy of racing these speedy, portable wintertime sailboats spurred their quest for a summertime sailing machine that could offer the same simplicity and excitement. It started with trimarans in the early 1960s. These designs progressed over 20 years of development and became very successful, winning many races. But they were too big, 24 to 30 feet wide. They wouldn't fit in a normal dock. They were difficult to haul in and out of the water. And as much fun as they were just a bit impractical. That's why Meade and Jan wanted to create a multi-hull that could be a top performer. Sail very fast, yet be safe, practical, and affordable.
Boy, if you could just make this little boat that could, you know, this little boat that could just do everything and still be low grief and still be able to go to windward in 40 or 50 knots of wind and yet still be able to go on a trailer behind a car. And we've always dreamed about this boat.
But there's other practical considerations of fast launching off from a trailer, being able to go under bridges by dipping the mast, being able to have a boat that was very fast and a lot of fun to sail. All of those things were absolute criteria that this boat had to pass, or we just weren't interested in pursuing any further in the project. So self-righting was the first major hurdle that we had to lick with this boat project. Once we achieved that, the rest of it fell right in line.
Though it would take a lot to capsize the Gougeon 32, the Gougeon brothers made sure that one person could ride it quite easily within a short period of time. Easy riding wasn't a new concept for the Gougeon brothers. Their experiences with rideable multi-hulls such as Splinter and Ollie helped them to create a sophisticated riding system for the Gougeon 32. A large masthead float provides buoyancy for the mast in the event of a capsize. This feature, combined with the riding pole and a few adjustments, can put the boat aright within 10 minutes. With a little practice, you could go through the entire riding sequence within 5 minutes. For performance and trailering purposes, it was crucial that the overall weight of the boat be kept to the absolute minimum. It had to be a strong, durable, lightweight structure that would maintain its overall hull stiffness for many years. This inspired the folks in the Gougeon test lab to develop the hydromat. The hydromat can be likened to a water-filled pillow. When placed against flat panels, pressures from 5 to 75 pounds per square inch can be evenly distributed. The panels are bent in two dimensions at once, rather than in the traditional one direction, realistically duplicating the kind of stress loads that boat hulls are subjected to on the water. They use this new system to run accurate and extensive fatigue tests on numerous composite materials, with all kinds of skin and core combinations. After 2 years of study, the team at Gougeon decided on an aerospace composite which could withstand repeated loads without softening.
It's one thing to come up with a very high-tech composite laminate, but it's quite another thing to manufacture a boat with this type of aerospace type of laminate in a cost-effective sort of way. And we were very lucky to have a whole group of people who had been working on some of these issues for a number of years pitch in here at Gougeon Brothers and solve some of the difficult dilemmas of using vacuum bags, using high temperature cures, using big ovens to properly bake the laminates out and come up with high temperature tooling.
The result of these efforts is a boat that's very strong, but light enough to be easily trailered by standard vehicles. And because of its narrow 8-foot 4-inch beam and shallow draft, you can launch it practically anywhere, and you can do it easily, within 5 minutes. Sounds awfully fast, but it's true because of its clever design. You simply screw on the masthead float with the VHF antenna. Lower the trailer with a simple linkage mechanism and winch. The side stays are permanent. All the halyards are hooked up. So you just lift the boom into place. Pull the mast into position. And back the boat off the trailer. It's just as easy when you're ready to take it out of the water. It neatly slides onto the trailer. You raise the trailer, move the mast over forward, let down the boom, remove the masthead float, and go.
This just really takes the grief out of the trailability thing. And you don't have to go to big fancy ramps anymore.